Hello. Today, on September 13th, we are going to be talking about Jesus as a teacher. So one of the things that Jesus did is he traveled around and he talked to people wherever they were. If they were getting water, he talked to them. If they were standing in the marketplace, Jesus talked to them. And sometimes people wanted to follow Jesus because he was so interesting and had interesting things to say. One of the ways that Jesus taught was to tell parables. And I know that I've told many of you before that parables are short stories that are designed to help people think about big, important ideas. And so on our timeline, we have this picture. And if you look on your Talk Together page that's in your bag, you'll be able to find your own picture where you can see Jesus in the center and you can look at the people who are paying attention and listening to him. Around the outside of Jesus are some symbols that represent some of the parables that Jesus told. So I hope you take some time to explore the symbols on this picture and imagine which stories they might belong to. So one of the things is that when Jesus was your age, everybody knew about sheep. And so Jesus told stories about sheep because it was something that people could understand. People understood about money just like we understand about money today. Jesus told stories about brothers and sisters, about the relationship between parents and kids, all things that we really understand today. When Jesus told parables, one of the interesting things is that they were always about things that were kind of special and kind of different from the ways that we usually think. And so we say that parables are countercultural. Counter means that it goes against, and culture means how we live and the way things are. So Jesus' parables went against the way that things usually are. So an example might be having a hamburger or pizza for breakfast and deciding that you're going to have Cheerios for dinner. That's kind of against the way we usually do things, isn't it? That's kind of countercultural to the ways that we usually eat. Now, that's a little simple example of what it means to be countercultural. And so Jesus talked about stories that went away or went against the way things usually are. So when you're reading Jesus' parables, which I hope you do this week, I have lots of them listed for you with some images on the Talk Together page. I hope you think, what is Jesus saying that goes against the way we usually think things are or have to be? You might not be able to come up with an answer right away, but that's the way it's supposed to be. Because parables should stick in your brain, and you should come back to them several times a day when you're not even thinking about them and say to yourself, is that what Jesus means? Is that what Jesus wants me to think about? Is this something that I should think about in a new and different way? So this week, I hope you think about Jesus as a teacher and remember some of the parables that he told and pay attention in those parables to how they go against the way things usually are. I miss seeing you. And I hope that you've enjoyed listening to this little tiny mini lesson. After you're done, you can find your sticker that has a picture of Jesus teaching in parables and put that into your passport under I listened to Pastor Stacy. All right, we'll do this again next week. Bye-bye.